Famcast Media.
Good afternoon, demons and demonesses. I got a little bit of a feel-good story for you guys. It's a lot different from my other, you know, news stories that I do. But, you know, this kind of surprised me, so I'm like, you know what, I might as well check this out. Now, this was sent to me by D. Rotten from the Dungeon Podcast, who pretty much sends me some of the most amazing stories ever, and my daughter wants to join in. Yeah, my daughter wanted to say hi, and she's now tearing up like my setup. Yeah, they're watching you. Yeah, they see you like right on the screen. Okay, so basically this story was sent to me by D. Rotten from the Dungeon Podcast, and he probably knew that I had a lot to say about this, so I'm gonna get on with it, Nam. So me and my daughter are gonna read this together for you. Former WWE wrestler Gabby Truff, known in the ring as Tyler Rex, has come out as transgender. Former WWE talent Gabby Truff has come out as a transgender woman. The 40-year-old fitness guru, who's wrestled under the ring name Tyler Rex, shared the news via a press release on Thursday, calling Gabby's journey a thrilling story of gender transitioning. Gabby is about to share her thrilling story of gender transitioning from a former WWE superstar, bodybuilder, fitness guru, motivational speaker, and motorcycle racer to a fun, loving, and fabulous female, the release read. She has been finally set free and ready to rule her world. The release continues saying, despite his success during and after his WWE career, Gabe was still wrestling with a secret persona dwelling deep within him. This a persona he has been hiding in the loud silence of his soul since childhood, the release continues. Finally, with the blessing of his loving wife Priscilla, Gabe is ready to reveal who he really is. He is now known as a she, a beautiful, wise, witty, and wonderful woman called Gabby. This is a story that wrestling and other sports fans, friends, and followers must not miss, especially many in the LGBTQ community. Dealing with challenging transgender issues, who Gabby and wife Priscilla are willing to help, the release goes on. The San Francisco-born wrestling star will share more about her transition in an in-depth interview on Extra this Friday. In character, the 42-year-old fitness guru professionally wrestled under the name Tyler Rex from 2007 to 2014. Countdown Gabby teased the tell-all Extra interview while opening up on Instagram Thursday, sharing an extreme close-up of her face and writing, "One day remaining." It seemed Gabby had intended to reveal the news on Friday, but she took to Instagram to address the early revelation. Thursday, sharing a photo of herself, beaming and posing in front of an old wrestling photo as she shared her new authentic look. The ball dropped early as Tuesday as this now worldwide news Truff shared. "This is me, unashamed, unabashedly me. This is the side of me that is hidden in the shadows, afraid and fearful of what the world would think. Afraid of what my family, friends, and followers would say or do. I am no longer afraid and am no longer fearful. I can say with confidence that I love myself for who I am. The previous 8 months have been some of the darkest of my entire life. The emotional turmoil of being transgender and having to face the world has almost ended me on multiple occasions. However, the day I stopped caring about what other people thought was the day I truly became limitless and allowed my authentic self to come into the light. My loving wife, family, and closest friends have accepted me for who I am. To them, I am forever grateful. Your support along the way means more than you ever will know." Another statement, Gabby also shared a press release on her Instagram that explained more info. She shared a glam selfie and urged fans to check out her Linktree for more information about her interviews and online ventures. "I don't expect everyone to agree or understand. It's not my place to change any of your core beliefs. Just know that the outer shell may change, but the soul remains the same. I know that many of you have questions, and as I have promised, they will all be answered tomorrow on Extra. My interview with Billy Bush airs worldwide. I have included a link to the bio of this interview along with my personal coming out video that explains everything. Waiting for Instagram to approve my name change and update the bio. Please see my story for the link in the meantime. I promise to always be transparent and truthful with my journey and to be a light for those that are in need. This is me. Love always, Gabby Allen Truff," she signed off. "When you are ready to show off all your cards
There will be nothing left to fear. Time's up, she continued. I'm no longer afraid. Fear has been replaced with the highest vibrational state of gratitude. Freed. She has finally been set free and ready to rule her world. The press release explained, Gabby will delve into the topic further with an in-depth interview on Extra this Friday. I am grateful for my past, for who I started this life as, for who I was, for who I am now, and for who I am becoming. Now, like I said, this is a really feel-good story. You know, the fact that, you know, her wife is supporting her through the transition, the fact that, you know, so many of her friends and family came out in support of her during their transition. And this is good for people who are transitioning, you know, so that way they have someone to look up to, letting them know that it's never too late to come out and live your true life and show who you really are to everybody. Because unfortunately, in some families and in some households, you don't always have that support group. You know, you don't always have that partner that's willing to, you know, accept you for who you are, that, you know, willing to judge you or have some sort of, you know, preconceived way about someone. And I'm just glad that, you know, Gabby thankfully had someone there that was, you know, accepting and open-minded and things like that. And not only is this good for, you know, fans of, you know, WWE and wrestling, but this is important and this means something to millions of people all over the United States. Millions of people who, you know, are still, you know, afraid to come out, or who are still, you know, living in the closet. And, you know, maybe this will be, you know, inspirational for them, you know, to actually come out, you know, reveal who they really are. You know, I can't even imagine, you know, having to go through 42 years of your life, you know, living something that you're not. So this is something that, you know, she's been struggling with and dealing with for a very long time. And, you know, I'm really happy for her. So now I'm not sure how many people are listening or how many, you know, eggs I have in my audience. But this is just a message and kind of go to show you that it's never, ever too late to transition. I remember a couple of years ago, there was a World War II veteran that came out as transgender in her 90s. I'm not sure if she was a member of the RAF or if she was a member of some other branch of the military. She might have been. Was she RAF? I'm not exactly sure. I'll have to re-edit this clip and edit that part in once I get more information. So her name is Patricia Davies, and she served in the British Army from 1945 to 1948. There's an interview of her, I think, on the BBC website and also on the New York Post, if you want to check it out. I mean, she served in World War II, so she's literally like a war hero. So much respect to her for that. You know, there's lots of other trans people I know that have served in the military and this and that and the other. But, you know, like I said, came out at the age of 90. Now, apparently, like, back in, like, the early 70s and 80s, she had told her wife, and what's even more surprising is back then, her wife was accepting of this. So, this also goes to show you, to, you know, any allies out there, you always have to, you know, be open and accepting and willing to understand and listen to, you know, your friends when they tell you this type of stuff. You know, don't chastise them, don't bully them. Don't ask them, you know, invasive questions or anything like that. You know, support them, you know, help them out, because this is like the most important time of their lives. You know, you wouldn't want somebody, you know, to ignore you during your time of need. So, you know, you have to show mutual respect for everybody. And I will say this, the world definitely needs more people like Gabby and especially Priscilla. But that's pretty much all I have to say about this. To Gabby Truft, all I got to say is congrats. You know, I'm proud of you. And to Gabby, all I have to say is I'm proud of you. I'm glad that you, you know, actually came out and you're being, you know, a positive image for, you know, members of the LGBTQ community, and that you're inspiring people who still haven't came out yet, giving them hope, giving them, you know, encouragement, inspiring them. But that's pretty much all I have to say. Up here in Jersey, we got more snow, so you guys are traveling, going back and forth to work, you know, stay safe, stay metal, hail Satan, and I'll catch you guys next time.